Thank you. Thank you. relation to what other people believe, whether they believe, and if so, what kind of God they believe in. Keith says God is just the adult's way of trying to scare you into doing what they want. He believes in what he sees, and no matter what's in front of him, he doesn't see much. I suppose Dad would say that about me if he knew what I believe. Maybe he'd be right, but it wouldn't stop me from seeing what I see. A lot of people seem to believe in a big daddy god, or a big cop god, or a big king god. They believe in a kind of super person. A few believe God is another word for nature. And nature turns out to mean just about anything they happen not to understand or feel in control of. Some say God is a spirit, a force, an ultimate reality. Ask seven people what all of that means and you'll get seven different answers. So what is God? Just another name for whatever makes you feel special and protected? There's a big early season storm blowing itself out in the Gulf of Mexico. It's bounced around the Gulf, killing people from Florida to Texas and down into Mexico. There are over 700 known dead so far. One hurricane. And how many people has it hurt? How many are going to starve later because of destroyed crops? That's nature. Is it God? Most of the dead are the street poor who have nowhere to go and who don't know the warnings until it's too late for their feet to take them to safety. Where's safety for them anyway? Is it a sin against God to be poor? We're almost poor ourselves. There are fewer and fewer jobs among us. More of us being born, more kids growing up with nothing to look forward to. One way or another, we'll all be poor someday. The adults say things will get better, but they never have. How will God, my father's God, behave toward us when we're poor? Is there a God? If there is, does he, she, it, care about us? Deists, like Benjamin Franklin and Thomas Jefferson, believed God was something that made us, then left us on our own. I wonder if the people on the Gulf Coast still have faith. People have had faith through horrible disasters before. I read a lot about that kind of thing. I read a lot, period. My favorite book of the Bible is Job. I think it says more about my father's God in particular and gods in general than anything else I've ever read. In the book of Job, God says he made everything and he knows everything, so no one has any right to question what he does with any of it. That Old Testament God doesn't violate the way things are now. But that God sounds a lot like Zeus, a super powerful man playing with his toys. The way my youngest brothers play with toy soldiers. Bang! Seven toys fall dead. If they're yours, you make the rules. Who cares what the toys think? Wipe out a toy's family, then give it a brand new family. Toy children, like Job's children, are interchangeable. Maybe God is a kind of big kid playing with his toys. If he is, what difference does it make if 700 people get killed in a hurricane, or if seven kids go to church and get dipped in a big tank of expensive water? But what if all that is wrong? What if God is something else altogether?